sponsored by
President Lai Ching-te, the newly sworn-in president of Taiwan, in his first address of concerns, called on China to cease its political and military intimidation against Taiwan and urged Beijing to promote a world that is free from the fear of more war. Lai's election marked the onset of the historic third consecutive term for the island's ruling Democratic Progressive Party, a party that has been hailed for championing democracy in the face of growing Chinese authoritarianism. Lai would be taking over the previous Taiwanese president Tsai Ing-wen. Lai took oath alongside the new Taiwanese vice president Tsao Bai-kim, who recently served as Taiwan's top envoy to the United States. The Chinese government openly lauds both leaders, envious of their championing for Taiwan's sovereignty. Notably, China claims Taiwan, a self-ruling democracy, to be a part of its territory without even ever having controlled the country. Meanwhile, in a veiled dig at China, Lai, in his very first presidential address, stated that the future of Taiwan is as important to the world as it is to the people of Taiwan, urging China to respect the choices of the people of Taiwan and choose dialogue over confrontation and exchange over containment. In response, China's foreign ministry spokesperson Wang Wenbin stated that Taiwan's pursuit of independence is destined to fail. The Communist Party of China, led by President Xi Jinping, termed Lai a dangerous separatist who would bring war and decline. For those adverse, doctor-turned-politician Lai won a three-way presidential race in January, securing an unprecedented third term for his part. Lai served as Tsai's vice president since 2020 and prior to that as her premier. Ever since the results of Taiwan's elections came, declaring victory of Lai Ching-te in January, China ramped up military incursions around Taiwan's water and airspace. Fortunately, such incursions by Chinese military in Taiwan territory have become a routine affair, triggering heightened fears of conflict. These constant incursions were labeled as the greatest strategic challenge to not only Taiwan, but to global peace and stability. Though the Chinese government is yet to issue an official statement on Lai's inauguration, the Chinese embassy in the UK held a press briefing over the weekend asking the UK government to not endorse it. Meanwhile, last week, a spokesperson for China's Taiwan Affairs Office warned that the island's new leader must seriously consider the question of whether he wants peaceful development or confrontation.